Insufficiently nourishing fish feeds present a major challenge for fish farming in Uganda. This issue ranks among the top five concerns faced by aquafeed producers, primarily due to a lack of understanding regarding the nutritional requirements of commonly farmed fish and crustacean species. However, a potential solution may emerge by 2024 as the Royal De Heers operating under the Caldice brand has taken the initiative to establish an advanced aquafeed plant in Njeru, Uganda. The state-of-the-art facility will have the capacity to produce 50,000 tons of feed annually. It will be the first dedicated aquafeed plant in Africa built by De Heers, demonstrating their commitment to improving feeding performance and driving progress in Uganda's agricultural sector and across the continent of Africa. The significant milestone of this groundbreaking facility was celebrated at the Model Farm Village in Njeru Municipality, Buikwe District. Distinguished attendees, including the Ugandan ambassador to the Benelux countries, that is Belgium, Netherlands, and Luxembourg, and the Dutch ambassador to Uganda, graced the event. Prominent political figures and representatives from the Dutch family-owned nutrition company delivered speeches during the ceremony, all focusing on enhancing aquaculture by improving aquafeeds in Uganda. Without further ado, let us delve into the ceremony and explore what De Heers has brought to Uganda.
Sanyuse nyo okubala ba mu kifo kino eno gye bayita Model Farm Village nge yakisangibwa mu Njeru Municipality Buikwe District. Ndi musanyufu nnyo kulaba nti nno basalawo ne balonda ekitundu kyange kino okuba nti nno baleetamu enkulaakulana eno egenda okwongera okutumbula ebyobulimi n'obulunzi mu Uganda. Era tuli basanyufu nnyo, ntwala omukisa guno okwaniriza mwenna abazze buli omu kitiikye, ba directors aba kampani eno. Tuli basanyufu nnyo era tubakakasa tugenda kukwatagana wamu nammwe, era nga tusaba n'ettaffaali tugenda okuteekawo leero nti twagala omukisa ogusookera ddala gubenga Model Farm eganyulwamu okutwalize wamu n'Enjeru Municipality. Tetwagala bantu kuva eri, twagala omukisa nga mwagutuwadde guventi nno era gutandikira wano tuventi nno tu abantu baffe baganyulwamu abanjeru tutwalize wamu ne Model Farm. N'olw'ebigambo ebyo sijja kwogera bingi, omukolo nguguddewo officially.
I want to take this honor on the behalf of the people of Njeru Municipality to welcome His Excellency the Ambassador of that and the other dignitaries who are here. On behalf of Njeru Municipality, we are grateful to have this investment, this project in Njeru Municipality. This is the first project or the first investment of this type, which is gonna be constructed in Njeru Municipality. We are grateful. I want to thank the government of Uganda and more so His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda, who has brought peace in this country. And I know very well it is because of this peace, the stability of this country, which has enabled all our investors to come in Uganda and invest in Uganda. As Ugandan is one of the challenges which we've been having is job opportunities. And this is what His Excellency has been battling for, to convince investors and to come in Uganda so that they can reduce that gap of job opportunity. I know very well the people of Njeru, having got the rules in this municipality, my people are gonna get opportunity of getting the jobs. I want to conclude by urging our director and the founder that let's put in jail on the front. Let's consider, as it has been stated by the chairperson of this local council of this area, that Injelo still need the opportunities of the jobs. Have many younger generation, younger people, every day they are approaching my office looking for a job. I pray that the first opportunity be given to the people of Injelo municipality and the country at large. I want also to urge that there are some social corporate responsibility which I know investors, our good investors, always do. And I would wish the host also to do the same. In case there are some opportunities, please, we welcome it. I want to conclude by committing our pledge of the leadership of Njelu Municipality to support this project in all ways. I want to assure you that as a political head of this municipality, we are ready to support you and see that this project excels.
During the groundbreaking ceremony at Njeru, the general manager of the De Heers Group took charge, accompanied by other directors, to unveil their ambitious plans for the upcoming plant. The significance of this plant extends beyond serving Uganda alone. It aims to positively impact East Africa and the entire continent of Africa by enhancing aquaculture around Lake Victoria through the production of top-notch feeds. Their intention was to inspire a sense of purpose and clarify the rationale behind selecting Uganda as the ideal location for their groundbreaking aquafeed facility.
So our intention is to build a 50,000 ton capacity fish feed plant right here in this location. It will not just serve the Ugandan market, but it will serve all of East Africa and can be expanded quite easily. It will provide feed for tilapia and other species if needed in the growing aquaculture sector, and should start to produce by the second half of next year. We are building on the foundations that Koudijs laid. With this new plant, we will gradually introduce the De Heers brand for aquafeed. Fish is a critical protein for the population and for food security. To state the obvious, Ugandans like to eat fish, and do so more than their neighbors. Open water nearly covers 20% of Uganda's surface, including almost half of that little pond across these hills. It has thus developed significant fishing and processing industry, and is estimated that nearly 1.5 million people work directly in capture fisheries. That the industry contributes to the livelihood of 5 million people, and it supplies about half the animal protein consumed in this country. But the problem is, this industry is inherently limited. It faces challenges. Wild catch will stagnate or decline, while there are more and more mouths to feed. Fortunately, aquaculture has been growing rapidly over the last few years, and the circumstances for growing tilapia in Uganda are exceptional. Steady and conducive water temperatures make sure you can grow tilapia year-long instead of in seasons, as in most of the country, most in the world. But this sort of aggressive growth of aquaculture is quite impressive, and the fish farmers here should be proud of it. Because to date, the infrastructure for fish farming has been falling short. Feed is the most critical element for fish farmers today. It needs to be available, it needs to be of good and consistent quality, and it needs to be offered at a reasonable price. At this moment, feed in Uganda is mostly imported, and this makes supply chain inflexible and expensive. With this new aquafeed plant, we will support fish farmers in providing healthy, nutritional, healthy, sustainable fish for all of East Africa. We hope that with locally produced feed, the industry will take flight. We want our customers to be successful, and besides feed, we will look at other gaps in the value chain and try to see where we can help. Not only will we as a company add jobs for Ugandans, but our real impact will be in the employment created under fish farmers and under our suppliers, the farmers of Uganda. Because instead of importing feed, we will buy local agricultural ingredients such as soy, maize, cassava, and all other agricultural ingredients you can think of. We will make local value chains work and will make Uganda less dependent on imports. Over time, we will strive to work closely with cooperatives and farmers to secure offtake and to increase yields and their businesses. We will also look to finding new ingredients, making systems more effective and less wasteful. This will be the host's first dedicated aquafeed plant in Africa. As Theo already mentioned, this is an expression of hope for the aquaculture industry around Lake Victoria. We will build a state-of-the-art plant and use our global expertise and experience to produce consistently high-quality feed. And we will continue introducing Dutch agricultural innovation to improve the business of the fish farmers. We will also strive to make this a model farm for future plants and aim for zero emissions. To circle back to the beginning, Ugandans like to eat fish. With this plant, we hope that we can help create a future where your children and theirs can keep doing so.
And like said, De Heus is the parent company of the famous brand Koudijs. A well-known brand, I think, here in Uganda. And very successful. Thanks to the help of course, Johan Vuk. I think many people of you know Johan here in the room. But also our partners there on the left of Kafika. They also are very responsible for this success here in Uganda. And a bit more background on the brand Koudijs. Koudijs is the export brand of De Heus. And we are present in the majority of African countries. But also worldwide, we're present in more than 60 countries. But now what's most important, and that's farmers. Farmers are, let's say, the center point of attention within De Heus in everything what we do. De Heus strives to improve the future and livelihood of farmers everywhere we are, so worldwide. So on the one hand, we have a lot of global knowledge and we combine that with very close local networks. So we want to be very close to the farmers. And we enable farmers in over 75 countries to increase productivity. And that's very important. But also to improve animal health, animal conditions. We also try to reduce environmental impact. And in the end, in many cases, establish a better future for the farmers, for themselves, for their families and their local communities. And we think that's very important too. So by investing in a local aquafeed factory here and supporting farmers to increase their productivity, we can contribute to a sustainably stronger fish sector and contribute to import substitution. And I liked what you said in your prayers. We have a long-term vision, but I never heard a vision of 1,000 years ahead, but maybe that's true. De Heus invests in the construction of a very advanced aquafeed production plant to demonstrate our belief and confidence in Uganda, in the economy here, and in aqua farmers specifically. Our local presence with a local organization is fundamental, we think, to further increase the growth and development of the farmers. Our employees all over the world consult with the local farmers every day. So we have a very big team also in Holland, in Vietnam, which will support also local farmers. We know their families and their farms. We support them with our global knowledge and help them to increase the performance of their businesses. The presence of De Heus and Koudijs in Uganda creates new jobs, like we already heard. I didn't hear the figure of 10,000, but maybe if you trickle down everything, that might be true in the future. We welcome them, particularly the new employees, in our company, knowing that their hard work will be and is, and their perseverance is that in the end will help local farmers to grow their businesses. These farmers, in turn, strengthen the Ugandan economy as well. Their success increases the availability of high quality and affordable food, animal proteins, in their local communities, which is why the Heus is proud of feeding the performance of the local farmers, of like we say, powering the progress here in Uganda. The Heus wishes, boom, there you are, you and your team, tremendous, a lot of success for everything and you've already done, and lots of success with the opening and building the business here in Uganda.
The Netherlands ambassador to Uganda extended congratulations to all those involved in the agriculture industry and the Heus for their remarkable achievement in Uganda. This achievement signifies a significant advancement for the agriculture sector, particularly in aquaculture, as it focuses on enhancing feed quality and addressing the issue of costly imports. By tackling the problem of expensive feeds, this milestone aims to uplift the fish industry in Uganda to a higher level.
The aquaculture feed factory that will be constructed here on this spot will target booming sectors in East Africa. And as you all know, both the aquaculture and the animal feed sectors are growing in this region. But animal feed is often expensive for farmers and the quality is suboptimal, as we have been explained just now. So the construction of a factory in which high quality feed will be produced will address a big growing demand and will combat some of the issues farmers are facing here in Uganda. As the Dutch ambassador, I am of course very proud to participate in today's ceremony to celebrate this important new Dutch investment here in the wonderful region around Jinja. The Heus will build on the good name of Koudijs and has already established in Uganda in the animal feed trade. So dear guests, allow me to point out that an important goal of the Netherlands Embassy in Uganda is to make a contribution to Uganda's agricultural transformation process as laid down in the Vision 2014. Our food security portfolio, our agricultural trade and investment activities, the Harvest Money Expo, and the Best Farmers Program are all aligned to this 2040 vision and are a clear sign of our commitment to the agricultural transformation agenda here in Uganda. The Netherlands Embassy here in Uganda is always ready to stimulate investments with advice, problem-solving activities, and other support. And like many of us here, we believe that farming is a business. Farming creates growth. By investing in commercial farming, family incomes increase, jobs are created, exports increase, profitable agribusiness pay taxes, and the entire economy booms. Uganda, as the rest of the world, faces a challenging period with post-COVID recovery, rising food prices, and the impact of climate change. So in the identification of the niches for value addition by introducing new, preferably green technologies, processing products and upgrading inputs provides lots of opportunities for Dutch companies to showcase their innovations and skills and for Uganda to expand and grow. And this is exactly what the Heus will be doing here. So as I conclude, it is my belief that investments like these of the Heus are a good example of what is needed to add value to primary production and bolster the agricultural transformation. So let me end by congratulating all of you, the Heus, Koudijs, the farmers, Jinja, the mayor, all of you present here today. This is quite an achievement. Congratulations.
Following the speeches, the Dutch ambassador to Uganda initiated the groundbreaking ceremony by placing the first brick on the ground, after which the other directors and political leaders followed suit.
Okay, let's have another break for one. One is now used to this. And one puts another song. Yes. Yeah, we clap, ladies and gentlemen. That's another break for future coming. Next one comes with Theo.
We had a conversation with the fish farmers following the momentous inauguration event, discussing their vision for this facility and their expectations regarding its potential to enhance the fish industry.
Free feed has been the hindrance to the growth. For many years, we've been importing feeds across the seas, and the main countries where we've been importing has been Vietnam, where Cowdiles has an operation, Brazil, where the Laguna has an operation, Egypt, Zambia, Mauritius, then partly Israel. So those are the countries that have been feeding Uganda with fish feed. And the feed that the farmers prefer are the floating pellets, because we operate in national environment, water body. So environmental conservation is our key priority in the choice of inputs that we make. And Cowdiles has been one of the key players as far as the supply of reliable fish feed quality is concerned. We've worked with them for, I think, close to 10 years now. And we are happy for this day of groundbreaking, because the biggest hindrance to the growth of aquaculture industry in Uganda has been lack of locally produced reliable quality of feed at affordable rates. Now we believe with local production that is going to source out raw materials from within the region, the issue of affordability is going to be realized. And the post-COVID challenge has also been the high freight cost of transporting this feed from wherever we are getting from. Take a case of example, those that have been importing feeds from Vietnam, Brazil, the freight cost rose from $3,300 to $9,000. That is only ocean transport to Mombasa. So transporting a container of feed of 26.5 tons has been costing farmers about $12,000, for example, in Kenya. The price of fish has not necessarily reduced, but because Kenyan shillings has lost against the dollar, even when you're still receiving the same price from the consumers, when you're exchanging that price to bring the money back to fund the operation, you lose through forex exchange.
We've been having a lot of challenges as fish farmers without having enough feed and good quality feed that led us to importation of the feed. Currently, since the company started, it started in 2006, and since then it has been a very big challenge for Sunfish Farm to access good feed for our fish. We've been importing our feeds from across the world. One of the countries that we've been importing the feed from is Brazil, and then Cowdiles, and then the other ones we've been getting it from Mauritius. And all these have been really a challenge to us farmers, because you have to take almost 4 months for you to access the feed, and it makes us to have a very big inventory and a lot of cash for us to be able to keep our stock available. So it's a great pleasure today that we are opening the ground break for Cowdiles to start producing the feed. Today's groundbreaking is a very big opportunity for ladies. In aquaculture, we see it's an industry that can easily be covered in also with the ladies. So we anticipate to see more ladies being employed, having more opportunities for jobs, including even the raw material supply, because it is an industry that will need a lot of raw materials that will be contacting the farmers. So we anticipate that at least the women are going to be part of this, to supply the ingredients, to work as the factory workers. So we really see opportunities for ladies to be part of.
In a discussion with Miriam Blaxo, the Ugandan ambassador to the Benelux countries, she urged the young population in Uganda to take advantage of the potential in cultivating soybeans. This is particularly important due to the increasing need for soy in aquafeed production, which is soon to be established in Uganda. This strategic decision not only signifies a wise investment, but also deserves praise for its contribution to job creation and attracting investors to Uganda.
Of course, what our main task is really is economic and commercial diplomacy, is to get more investors to our country so that we can create more jobs, we can create economic prosperity. And what is very important is that when we talk about investments, yeah, we talk about people who know their jobs. And I think the Netherlands, being the second largest exporter of agricultural produce in the world, they are only second after United States, have a lot for us to learn from. So we couldn't be more pleased, you know, at this fantastic and auspicious occasion today to be welcoming Koudijs de Heus on the groundbreaking ceremony for this incredibly important investment. First of all, it's import substitution, because Koudijs de Heus have been importing a lot, containers, hundreds and hundreds of containers over the years with aqua feeds, because we were not making it here ourselves. And you see what the incredibly important thing to know is, that's why I like to work with Koudijs de Heus, is because they have a vision. Yeah? What happened is that all the fish feeds that they've been brought into this country, of course, are expensive. And I tell you why they're expensive. Koudijs de Heus, we visited their factories in the Netherlands. Yeah? They are very, very big. And they have factories all over in the Netherlands. But what they do, the soya and maize, mostly soya, they import it on large barges, container ships, to the Netherlands. There they add their proteins and vitamins and whatever make our fingerlings, the little fish, grow. And then they export that product to us. So why chasing the whole world, very expensive, in order? And so Koudijs de Heus realized, why should we do this? We can as well, Uganda being the most fertile country in Africa.
Of what significance does the installation of the aquafeed plant hold for Koudijs?
We're going from importing to important. No. Yeah, eventually, yes, of course we will be exporting. No, but we have realized that here, this is the capital of agriculture of Africa, more or less. So that's why we think it's necessary to stop the importing eventually. I mean, if possible, but then, yeah, of course, we have to be on ground. This is where it happens.
In 2018, De Heus entered the Ugandan market through its brand, Koudijs, which has become the dominant supplier of livestock feeds in most of the market. Due to the high demand for fish as an important source of protein in Uganda, coupled with a growing population and limited wild fish catch, the aquaculture industry has seen consistent growth. Uganda benefits from favorable conditions for fish farming all year round, thanks to its extensive lakes and suitable temperatures. To sustain this growth, farmers require reliable fish feeds. De Heus aims to address this need by constructing a dedicated aquafeed plant in Uganda and sourcing local ingredients such as maize, cassava, soy, and other available resources to the maximum extent possible. That concludes today's episode of the Harvest Money Show on Urban TV. We wish you a blessed week. Until we meet again.